The only reason I chose it was that it was two syllables, easy to say. Dyson. The big advantage I had was that I was a person in charge and responsible for this company. I'm to blame. I'm the one you come to if something goes wrong. I'm responsible for it.
British inventor James Dyson has just released the book titled Invention: A Life. It's an inspiring account of the career of the man behind Dyson vacuum cleaners, Dyson fans, Dyson hair dryers, Dyson air purifiers, and many others. In 2019, Mr. Dyson moved his company's global headquarters from the UK to Singapore. He's also a permanent resident here. We're meeting over Zoom to talk about his book. He's having breakfast in his UK office in Malmesbury, and I'm having tea in my office in Topayo. When did you decide to come up with, this autobiography? Because you had one, written one in the 90s.
It's 54 years or something since I graduated. Right. So it caused me really to think back over my life as to what happened and what I thought was important, particularly on the subject of education. The thing I realized is that experience has been of very little value to me at all. And I think in this increasingly fast-moving world, experience is of little value. It's changing so fast, the conditions are changing. So knowing what has worked in the past really doesn't help you at all now. Mm. In fact, it does almost the opposite. It's a hindrance. It gets in the way. So the aim of the book and the timing of the book is really around those events.
What is your working style like, throughout all these years?
I work hard. I hope it's collegiate. And of course, right at the very beginning, I worked on my own, and then gradually I built up teams, which I much prefer to working on my own. We sit down and we review projects and try and find solutions to things and the best way to do things. And I don't mind silly suggestions. In fact, I encourage them. I think naive curiosity, naive questioning, wrong suggestions are good ideas. They're good ideas because it's this point about experience. If an experienced person will only put forward a sensible suggestion, which might work, whereas a naive person or a young person who is unafraid to make mistakes, will ask the wrong question, will make an outrageous suggestion, which might actually be a very good idea.
Can we talk a bit about the car, the electric car? Do you consider that a failure?
No, not at all. I thought that we were in a very good position to do a car, and we had some interesting ideas as well, like very big wheels and putting the wheels on all four corners and so on, to make a better car with lower rolling resistance, greater comfort and off-road capability. So we thought we could do a good car. What changed, of course, was Dieselgate. Dieselgate changed everything, because then all the incumbents said, wow, we've got to do electric cars. And of course, there then became great international and government pressure to remove the internal combustion engine from the streets by 2030. Mm-hmm. And suddenly, we had the specter of everybody making electric cars. That didn't worry us too much. What really worried us was that people were making huge losses making electric cars.
Right.
They're making 20,000 pounds loss on making an electric car. And we couldn't compete with that.
Right.
Because I can't afford, as a private company, I can't afford to lose the sort of money that Elon Musk has over the years. So we realized that it was just too dangerous to continue with it.
Thank you for making Singapore your global HQ.
Oh, no, we're completely delighted to do that. And it's really important. Partly because Singapore is hugely supportive of companies that are developing technology and manufacturing it. You have so many bright young engineers who we're absolutely delighted to work with. You've got great universities, so we're working with your universities doing various projects. I can't talk about them, but they're really important. It's a brilliant place to be. Although we started as a British company, the Asia is our most important market, and we've got to be in Asia. to make it work, to make it successful and to understand it. It's be just arrogant to think we could do it from England. You can't. You've got to be in Asia.
Do you think Dyson will be around for the next 50, 100 years?
Well, I hope so. I hope so. And, you know, I hope it'll be an exciting 50 and 100 years.
Right.
And I know the people who are here at the moment will make it that. But and I believe my son will as well. And I hope my grandchildren, come here to work for a week occasionally. And I hope one of them will have enthusiasm for it as well. They do at the moment. I hope they retain the enthusiasm they have at the moment.
So, Sir James, thanks very much for, you know, breakfast and your time.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.